eating. Ballin' all season. I got a sales sign. Tell me if you need it. Bust another play. A knock, knock, knock. Bitch, I'm on grind mode. Need a lot, lot, lot. Yeah, moving and I'm grooving. I ain't with the stupid nigga. I ain't with the.
Let's get started.
The first step to finding the perfect therapist for you is knowing what kind of help you're looking for. Psychology is a very broad field. There are many different areas that a psychologist can choose to specialize in. There is clinical psychology, psychiatrists, family therapy, youth therapists, grief therapists, even sex therapists. The list goes on. So it's best to have a good idea about why you need help and what you're looking for before you decide who's going to be your therapist. Remember that not all therapists do the same things or offer the same treatment, so it's best to pick a few different options. Here's what to look for. Studies have proven that people are more likely to stay in therapy when their therapist is the same race as them. So when you're choosing a therapist, here are three important things that you should be looking for. Race, sex, and age. And here's why. It's no secret that racism spews its ugly face into every facet of American culture. It's in our medical field, it's in our school systems, it's in our judicial systems, and you won't be surprised to know that it's also in the mental health field. Racial biases play a key factor into why some people just do not continue therapy. No one wants to feel misunderstood, unheard, and judged. It's best to pick a therapist that you know you're going to feel the most comfortable with. When I was looking for a therapist, I knew right away it had to be a black woman.
Girl magic for real.
I knew that within a certain age range, we wouldn't be able to understand each other. And so I really, really paid attention to how old my therapist was. Also, I kind of just dug into her background a little bit. I made sure to look for any accolades, make sure that they actually are certified, any degrees, any awards, certification, reviews on the therapist, if any. Like, I was looking for everything. I was being really nosy. I wanted to know who I was going to trust with my most vulnerable parts of myself. So I most definitely was all in these people business, as you should be, as you should be. This is big. This is important. This is the first step to a lot of healing. So you got to do it right. You got to choose the right one. You may be wondering, where am I going to find all of this stuff? Google, people. All I did was Google psychologists near me, and there was a whole list of websites that came up. Check the description box for these, but therapy.org, help.com were some of the greatest websites ever. They really gave you a full background of therapists in your area and the degrees and stuff that they have all in one place. So it was really, really awesome. Next, we're going to discuss payment. How much does therapy cost? This is really hard to answer because each therapist is different, just like each client is different. It's important to know that payments may vary depending on your specific treatment plan. However, I do want to myth that therapy has to be expensive. Many therapists accept all types of insurance, even Medicaid. To find out if a therapist accepts your insurance, simply contact them and inquire about which insurance companies they do work with. No Medicaid? No problem. There are still options for you. Finding out about free mental health services in your state can be as easy as a simple Google search. Seek out any government-funded programs as well as community programs. Free call-in lines. If you're in college and don't have access to a car, please inquire about any counseling services your university or school may offer. Quite sure most high schools and middle schools have some type of therapist, eye care specialist, on campus. Is this therapist for me? So outside of your first appointment jitters, being nervous, feeling like you told them too much, that you may look crazy or sound crazy, here's how you would know if a therapist is for you. So my top thing, my number one thing is professionalism. This is a person that you're going to be trusting with the most intimate parts of yourself. You want to ensure that your person is handling you in the utmost professional manner. Is their office a professional space? Are they handling you and other clients in an ethical manner? Meaning, when you come in, they're not discussing their previous client with you or not leaving you in an area where you can overhear a client before you. Do you feel heard when you're speaking? Are they answering emails, picking up calls in the middle of your session, sending texts. Number three, do you feel relieved or better after talking to them? Or do you feel like the issue wasn't resolved and you leave with more problems and worries than you did before? This next one may take a few appointments to figure out. Is it easy to talk to them? Do you still have anxiety when you speak to your therapist? Do you feel like you're being judged? Instead of it being a safe space to feel like you can decompress and be your truest self, does communication flow? Meaning, does your therapist just talk over you and want to give you answers? Or are they really giving you the space you need to properly vent and let out things? My last tool is relationship and availability. Do your therapists go out of their way to make you feel like you're a part of something? And when I say that, I mean, is there a relationship there? Are you still feeling like this is the very first time you stepped into their office? Or have you guys developed a rapport to where you're very comfortable? This is someone that you want to speak to about your problems and your needs and availability. Can you ever get a hold of your therapist? Or are you constantly having to check on your therapist, reschedule appointments because they're not able to keep your appointments and things of the sort? Or do you feel important to your therapist? And that's important because therapists can have many different clients and you want to feel like in that moment you have all of their attention. As always, stay healthy, stay happy, and wash your fucking hands.
If you guys are loving this Mental Health Matters tea, please check out Ms. Glenisha Howard at the mentalhealthoutlet.com. Links will be in the description box. Until next time.